What's going on, it's D-Man. In this video, I'll be breaking down Pro-Am and what I want to see in NBA 2K18's Pro-Am mode. Now, I'm going to go ahead and dive into it, and I'm going to say it right off rip. In 2K18, we have to have private lobbies, and to be honest, I would be shocked if 2K18 launched without private lobbies in Pro-Am. Especially with Pro-Am being the face of esports for 2K, it really starts with private lobbies. In my team, you can play your friends, all-star team up, you can play your friends, even in my park, via my court, 3v3, that's a private lobby. It's only right that Pro-Am gets it, especially since it's the face of esports. With private lobbies and 2K18, you'll be able to scramble top teams, you'll be able to play your friends, you'll be able to start those leagues up that people do. And I mean, I really shouldn't have to explain it. Private lobbies are a must for NBA 2K18. So let's go ahead and switch over to the reward system for Pro-Am. In NBA 2K16, you pretty much play Pro-Am just to play it. And I respect that. I mean, that's what we did back in the day. You play just to play. But I still feel like there needed to be a reason to play. So in NBA 2K17, 2K came out with a different tier system. You have Amateur, Pro, Elite, and you can work up to Elite 6. When you hit Elite, you got the option to customize your jersey and your court. And if you keep grinding, go up the tiers to Elite 6, you'll earn sponsorships for your team, which means you're able to earn more VC. Now, I don't have a problem with this system. I think that it should be taken a step further, though. For example, a lot of people miss the actual arena we had on NBA 2K16, and I won't lie to you, I do too. So, for example, we can say Amateur, you get the current court that you have now in the game. For Pro, you can get like the college national championship court you have in my career. And for Elite tier and up, you can have the actual arena. And I feel like people will be happy with that. But even then, you can keep going further. Elite 4 and up, you can get the outdoor hardwood court. Elite 6, I know Ronnie joked about an underwater court. I mean, is it lit though? That will be lit. You know, just something to make you keep grinding. That's all I really want. And I know Jay Fox brought this up in one of his previous videos a while ago. The rewards for my park are way better than Pro-Am. For my park, you're immortalized in 2K18. You get attribute upgrades. And that's really the big one, because I know 2K trying to make players play all modes of the game, but I know people that just want to play Pro-Am. That's all they play, Pro-Am. There are people that only play my career. So really, to me, in my opinion, it's not fair to have that big of a reward for one mode, my park. Or if you have something like that in my park, you have to have something nice too for Pro-Am and my career people. So if you want people to dive into the actual Pro-Am mode, the incentive has to be there. But right now, I do feel like 2K17 was a good stepping stone. I could say it's going in the right direction. As of right now, you get more VC in Pro-Am walk-on. You get rep in Pro-Am walk-on, so most people just play that. Which is cool, people can do what they want, but if you're trying to push esports and Pro-Am, then, I mean, you gotta get people inside the actual Pro-Am mode. That's my opinion. So we're gonna switch it up and talk about the actual Pro-Am mode a little bit more. Now, we're gonna start off with the roster, which is something I wanted to see come back. If there's a roster, then there's a GM, therefore, people can run without the team leader or GM being there and still get wins for the team you're on. Now, that was not possible in 2K16. So, of course, I like this format better. But there is one thing missing from 2K10 and 2K11. And that is the option to promote somebody as GM. So, let me tell you what's going on. I'm going to use my boy Bud as an example. So, I'm not the GM of my team. I can run with whoever I want to. Every once in a while, Bud will hit me up. He'll say, come through, play some Pro-Am. I'm about it. Now, let's say we want to switch it up. Let's say my squad need one. And I say, you know what? Bud, come through. Come play Pro-Am. Bud can't be about it because he's the GM of his team. In order for him to play with us, he has to disband his team and then come through. Now, on 2K10 and 2K11, what we would do is just promote somebody else in the team as GM. That would have made Bud a free agent, and he could come through. Then go back to his team. They will still have their record and still have their rank. So that's the one thing I need back. Promote to GM is a must. Now let's talk about in-game. One thing that really stood out to me about NBA 2K17's Pro-Am mode is making defensive adjustments And that really saved us in a lot of games. But once again, it's one of those things that we can take further, in my opinion. Changing the assignments on defense, it works well when you're in man-to-man, but I still feel like we should be able to call zone 2-3, 3-2, etc. That would help with that leave assignment, D-grade, and also when you run with CPUs or when people get kicked, you'll still be able to sit in that zone if you want to, although a CPU sitting in zone, I don't know about that one. But even then, you should be able to do it. And same on the offensive end. On 2K11, we had play art. We could call plays. I used to run that 1-2 lob. Y'all don't know about that. We still run the 1-2 lob. Phoenix playbook. Y'all don't know about that. Let me chill. But either way, play art on the offensive end would be great too. Once again, we had it in 2K11 in crew mode. Just bring it back, especially with the plays now. I'm not saying teams have to run plays all the time, but every once in a while, it'll still be good to see a team cook something up. Just my opinion. One of the most important things I want to talk about is the matchmaking also. This year, something I like. Skill-based matchmaking was introduced to Pro-Am, but I still don't know how I feel about skill-based matchmaking. If anything, I believe it's probably too strict. For example, if you hit Elite 6, you will only play Elite 6 teams. Or Elite 5 teams. And that's cool and all. But the problem is, you'll end up playing the same people over and over. Like, I can't even count the amount of times I've seen Throwdown versus Godlife. And if you're not in a match versus a team you play all the time, you're probably searching for a match. And that searching can go on 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. I've seen a tweet from other teams in other regions. They may be in Europe, they may be in Asia. But they hit Elite 4. And they gave up trying to find a match. They can't find anybody. So, skill-based matchmaking is cool, it's good. But if you have to tone it down a bit, I understand. And I'm pretty sure the other teams will understand too. Right now, skill-based matchmaking is way too strict. So now I want to talk about something that was in 2K11 and also 2K10, I believe, too. Maybe not 2K10. My memory isn't that good. But definitely 2K11. But game track. We need that in Pro-Am, my team, playing out online. We just need game track back because game track was crucial. And if you didn't know what game track is, I'll break it down real quick. At the end of your game, you can go to the menu, click on game track, and it will show every time somebody scored. And you can go to that play and get a replay. It's simple. I know it sounds simple, but trust me, it's money. Everybody wants that game track back. They just don't know it yet. Believe me. Especially if you're a YouTuber, whether it's simple stuff like to get a thumbnail or to make a mix. I mean, game track is just good to have. Also, speaking of post-game, I would also like to be able to view the bot score again, just like you could last year. I mean, my squad, we go by numbers. If we have a close game or even if we lose a game, we look at the bot score. We look at the team score, see what we did right, see what we did wrong. And I don't know, stuff like that, they took out of 2K17, and I know a lot of people are not talking about it, but me, I would like to see it back. Now, I'm going to keep the video short, so I'm going to end it right here. If you have anything you want to see in 2K18's Pro-Am mode, leave it in the comments below. Although, I'm pretty sure I know what people are going to say. Y'all going to say something about the commentator. Y'all going to say something about people on the bench. Personally, me, I'm cool with playing just the whole game with my mod player. I'm kind of past the bench mindset that was back in crew. I'm kind of past that. So that's why I didn't talk about it. But if you want to see it, leave it in the comments below. Also, truth be told, in Pro-Am, I'm going to need those referees to be out of the way in 2K18. They get in the way a lot. But other than that, I'm chilling. Pro-Am, in my opinion, a step in the right direction. A few things missing from 2K16 that we can get back in 2K18 and then just add on to 2K17 and we should be good. So like I said, leave a comment below. Holler at you all later. Peace.